we're up here quite a ways. Okay, we got the chipper in place. This is a unique job. Look at this monster. That's a, I don't know, 65 inch diameter silver maple. Look at it. I don't even know, there we go. Yeah, massive canopy. But we got this. Great big lead. And if we can see, shield my son here, right at the top of there, that's all the K going right down into there. Right down into there is all the K, and we got two big branches on there and a third smaller one. So, you know, it's kind of stage one removal, but we've got so much mass here. You know, yeah, we take this off here, we're going to get decay. There's already, you know, big wound there, a big one came off earlier. So the decay is obvious, but you know, there's so much mass here. This isn't just gonna tip over right now. And we're gonna reduce this branch back, and we don't have a whole lot of drop zone over here. So, we might have to do some kind of speed line or something. But we got, obviously, we got a nice high canopy. I'll probably have to climb out of the lift. But, I mean, this, look at the structure on this thing. It's got a great canopy, except for this, you know? Anyway, so we're gonna save this old girl. Mark just arrived. Take this limb off. No, I called her an old girl, not you. So I don't know, what do you think? We just string this, set up a block over here, and then bring it right down here into this area.
We have permission from the neighbor to...
Yeah, he's 90. Oh. And he's glad to see something coming off.
He's got a lovely little backyard.
We'll probably reduce this other branch here too. It's over this 90-year-old's house. Get that, that'll make him feel safer.
Yeah, and when we get to wood, we can put the block right there.
Yeah, right. Just bring it right down by the...
And he comes and, yep.
Yeah, all right.
I like it, good plan.
We'll put the lift right here. I'll come up and through.
Oh, you can. Well, you got two sides.
Yeah, we got access there too. But I think we got such a nice chipping spot here. We'll just bring it around here.
Let's get that beast unloaded and truck swapped, and maybe by then, let's go Brandon and be here.
Yeah, we'll be ready to go. All right, somebody was asking about our trailer. It's a Midsota trailer. We got a couple dings on it already, but very nicely built, totally steel deck. We put in some corners. We just got short chains, so we have a short chain on all four corners. That works really nice for locking this thing down quickly and easily. And then we have, you know, a ratchet on every corner. And up here, you got, you know, ratchets in all corners. So that's pretty cool. That works out well. Good hard plywood sides. You can put hanging strips on there. We added those accessories to hang all our stuff. And it just fits. It's 81 inches wide. We're 83 between the wheel wells. So no room to spare. It kind of squeaks on the side walls a little bit, but tires are 2.5 years old and they're holding up well. So when we bring some block, we made some blocking that we put up here. It helps us on greater slopes to gain a little bit more. They now have adapted the outriggers on the newer machines
you can get actually, they're longer or they're something. You can get a higher angle. So that's cool. We could upgrade those actually, I think they told us. But we've got the blocking, so that works out pretty good. But it's a complete tilt that locks down on both sides. And then we've got, you know, a hydraulic lift. So it'll lift the whole machine, trailer, up. Are we unlocked over there? Yeah, I mean, it'll lift the whole machine. But this baby loads heavy end first. So our tongue weight on this is, I mean, it's gotta be 4,000 or 5,000 pounds. We check those bolts, you know, all the time. You can see they look pretty new. It's because we replace them proactively. Because it is a really heavy, you know, it's 10,000 pound machine, 10,500 or so. Now the 92 footer, this is 72 foot. The 92 foot actually stows up like 18 inches shorter. So we could move this back 18 inches. That would really help. So as it is, you know, we fold this in and the basket's right here. Well, if we had another 18 inches, we could back this up. We'd be closer to our wheels and we'd lighten up the tongue weight quite a bit. So the 92 is actually a shorter stow than the 72, just for the record. All right, so we're gonna get this baby unloaded. All right, so we turn on the main switch, turn on the button there. You gotta flip it to the perforated line. You push the little black button. We're gonna wait for that to blink 3 times. Now we gotta wait 10 seconds. A glow plug is 5 seconds. Probably don't need to use the glow plugs on these days, but we usually always do. So 5 more seconds after the first glow plug. In the winter time, we might run 2 glow plugs, and then you're ready to go, and you push the start button. And she started. So that's the starting procedure. And we gotta raise the boom. So we got the boom up. Shut it off and restart the starting procedure to get it into the basket mode. Now I can just turn it to the basket right now and then go around and start it in the basket. Not gonna put outrigger pad here. We'll wreck less flowers. and the ground's pretty solid these days. We tied a little throw line that we don't like onto these so we don't lose them. Look at this. And sometimes on unlevel terrain, we don't use the outrigger pads because it wants to slide. But with these blocks over here, so these blocks we just screwed together 4x4s, treated, and a couple of deck boards, 2x4s screwed together so that we can make different combinations to get a level surface. And then this thing self-levels beautifully. One on two of these, we're good. I think it'll probably function. Yep, so we're leveled. So I could have set that outrigger pad a little farther forward. We're right on the corner. It'll be fine. But they slide in. So cheat the outrigger pad towards the inside, you know, to account for that. I'm all the way on this one here. We're gonna be fine. So that's getting her level. Easy. We've dinged all these lights. We gotta replace all of our blinking lights. But those are a luxury feature that we got for free when we originally did it. They're really easy to knock out. And we found some aftermarket ones that are a lot cheaper. So there are stuff you can get to fit in there. We just have to get around to fixing them. But it's a nice luxury to have lights, but it stops when it's level. So if you just know the feel, you can get her done. So I think we're all set up. I'll be able to get up into the middle of the canopy. I'm probably gonna climb out and do a lot of it. I think I'm lined up here. I'll be able to work the trunk here really close to it. So maybe I need to shift over. I don't have much room to shift over though. So I think this is gonna work really good between climbing and the lift. We'll get this done. But from this position, I'll be able to get this limb back here and all this deadwood on this side. So should be good. So we put all the outriggers down. We're disconnected because we haul the big trailer with this. It's really nice. Just drives like you don't even have it. So we'll be hooking back up with the Chevy to this. So we just leave it. But we got the back outriggers down. This thing sits here really nicely. It's 12,000 pounds, so it's not like you bump it around and it moves. So that'll shoot right in there at an angle. And we're good to go. Ready to rock. All right, 2 hours of prep. We got a nice setup here. I'm tied in, I'm gonna climb out. We're up here quite a ways. That's our limb, that's the top of our limb, all that decay. Yeah, this is a good idea to take this out. So it goes all the way up to here. Yeah, it's pretty tall. So we've got this pretty high rigging point here. We'll be able to rig that out. Might take that other limb off that's right there. We'll see. It's got a big piece of decay right there. So we might have justification. We gotta take that piece off that goes to the neighbor anyways. So we'll see. But I'm gonna set up the phone to get this. Thank you. rigged up for the first rig after lunch. So I don't have to move the lift at all. I can kind of squeeze underneath, come up from underneath those laterals over here. And I can scoot right up there and reach that. So that's cool. It's a nice tree. Time for lunch.
All right, we got this thing hooked up for a lift. It's gonna flop off of there a little bit. Suppose we could have lit this thing up.
Balanced. Now pull that as far out as you can, maybe you can get it with the loader. Just make a nice pile there. Make a nice pile right there like that, and we'll just come and pick them off. Oh, I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 or 5 picks here. Then we're done.
Better up for a lift.
Gonna get heavier from here. That's the way I wanted it, right like that.
This can't be 1,500 pounds.
Yeah. This needed to go. You want to send another block up? Oh, wait. I got a block right here. I'm going to put an angle in here.
Yeah, I'm going to so that we get a little more compression for it. Change the angle of that rope a little bit. It'll just be a little. All right, so what we did,
I changed the angle of that rope so that we aren't jerking right on that limb. We're coming down at a back angle slightly. So this back line is at least in line with the angle of that limb up there. So we've reduced a little bit of the stress on that high anchor point. And I'll take a shorter piece yet on this next one. Just because we're getting fatter and fatter as we get to the bottom. And actually, we've been decayed here so far, so now we're gonna be a little more sound wood at the bottom. Just what I wanted. Nice little drift away. Hey. Well, it's a pretty day, guys. And hey, unlike an all-day removal, a lot of the shade is still around. If we were removing it, the shade would be gone. Uh-oh, paparazzi.
This is going to go viral for sure.
Just tell all your friends to go to the Game of Trees. Can you pull my rope out of the way, out the other way? Somewhere, Brandon. Are you saying I should go all the way up and take it down? It's canopy tied. Right next to the block, so I thought I'll just go get it later. Don't make me go get it now. No, I don't want to cut that. It's like spinning around. My lanyard is all wrapped around me. All right. Okay. Why don't you tell me I had my lift running the whole time? Sneak in from here. Trying to avoid the pinch. About 28 inch diameter. Well, this is going to work out good. I can make the finish cut, right?
We want to lift.
I think we're going to lift on this last
one.
It's
not bad. It's starting to sag pretty close.
Yeah, we'll take out the canopy there for sure. Get the rope out of the way, and then I'll clean it up. We were trying to lift that without cutting that rope. All right, now pull my rope out of the way. we should laser the Game of Tweez insignia right on this baby.
Like a chainsaw carver.
All right, good enough for this application. Almost there. You know how to wreck a guy's day. It is a military surplus bag. Mark is making fun of the rope bag I have for that ribbon rope. You can see it down here.
he said the 90-year-old guy next door said that was his duffel bag on the USS Arizona.
That's Mark's way of insulting me for having, you know, makeshift rope bags. It's a good bag. The handle's broke on it currently, but it's a good bag. Yeah, why don't you bring it home on the weekend, Mark, and fix that bag for me? I kind of have sentimental value of that bag. It was my grandpa's bag on the USS Arizona. What if it was that and you're just making a flippin' joke about it? What if that? Wouldn't that be Travis? Yeah, hopefully he wasn't on the Arizona at the inappropriate time. Might be too soon for an Arizona joke. Here comes a rope. Could whiplash you. See if I had to physically climb up here to get these blocks. I once did. Well, boys, that was a big pruning. Rolling right across that blacktop. As long as you're not setting it down in the client's driveway. Yeah, they're only treating them for their proactive removals. What? Yeah, that's what the city's proactive plan. You take off your brake. You don't have your emergency brake. Yeah, you let yourself roll forward and roll out from underneath it. No, you can't be in drive. Oh, you won't roll forward. So yeah, you have to drive forward and then take it back out. I'm coaching Brandon how to put down the swap loader box. There's a little bit of nuance and tricks to it. I'll guarantee you it's operator error. Yeah, make me come out there and do it. Don't want to hit his grill. I think I miss it. Oh, that's close. Almost got those lines on my helmet. Missed the rake by a couple of inches. I don't think I fit between you. Door open on the truck. This might actually be possible. Wow.
Wow, this is really jerky.
A little bit of rock and roll.
Trailer down. And if my wheels are inside the door here, we're good to go. Three blinks, 10 seconds later. Oh, is that 10 seconds? Seconds. Boom up. Hold the basket. Done, folks. We gotta tie this bad boy down. So the question I have is, what's the high temperature tomorrow if the low temperature is 78? Well, all right. Well, folks, I think that's the end of our day. Eli put another job on, but what time is it, guys? I don't know. It's 3:30 or something like that. Where'd you put my truck? Is that your last piece?
Love that.
CTX 160, it handles them. That's not 2,000 pounds, I'm telling you. It's not 2,000 pounds. Brandon was trying to tell me that was 2,000 pounds as he's looking at the log chart. I'm just like, no way. A man's looking at the log chart. You can't get it right. I tell you why I oughta. So here's our tree, folks. It's looking stellar. Looking stellar. Clear the house, clear the antenna. They might get a couple more channels on their TV. We got one more chunk, two more chunks of wood. Oh, one more and some chippings. See how Brandon does. Nice job, Brandon. Oh, he's on film now. He's choking. He's got it. There we go. Look at that. We've rebuilt that grapple a number of times, Vermeer. This is what we do with them. Make them tough the first time. Beautiful tree, still standing. It's Game of Trees, we're having fun. See you next time, like and subscribe.
postscript. Mark and Brandon failed to notice I left a block in the tree. How's that for extreme ownership? I was sitting out front talking to the clients and I'm like looking up in the tree and there is the block, the remote block I put in to kind of change the angle of the rope. So I paid for putting that block in. And like and subscribe because we're really working for this. All right, take care.
Playing the game of trees.